and welcome back to my channel Origami with Chapchu. Today we're going to make something really simple and interesting that even a 5-year-old can make it. And I call it the shooting zigzag toy. And it looks something like this. So I will show you how it works. Hold ends here and you pull them apart. So this is how it works, you pull them and it springs towards. Isn't that cool? So I'll show you how to make it. Let's begin. So before we start, I will show you two types of basic folds. A mountain fold, which is something like this. When you put the two edges downward and you see a spike pointing upward like a mountain fold. And it looks like a mountain. So the next type of fold is a valley fold, which is when the two edges are going up and then the arrow is like, it's an arrow and it's pointing downwards and it looks like a valley. So now that you know both of the folds, this model is basically just a mix of the two folds and this is the basic pattern. So if you want to make this, you should at least know how to make this pattern. Now you know how easy that is. So begin with a rectangle sheet of paper, any color, and start by folding this edge to this edge, like this. And now we turn over, fold this edge up so that it aligns with the screen. And this time, fold really, really sharply. Crease really, really sharply. Open it up, so you should have something that looks like this. A mountain fold here and a valley fold here. So now we turn over again, make a tear over here, and also turn other side and make a small tear also on the line here. And now you put it up like a ridge and tear it apart. Now why I put a tear at the end also is because if you don't do it, then the corner might extend or it might rip apart a bit of the paper. So we won't be needing this, we only need this. And so you can use this in one of my other videos. So I'll keep this aside first. So now we begin like this and fold it in half. This can be made by any size rectangle, but this is actually the best size you can do. It's also really good because it's long and it's thin, which is good for the shooting. So now we fold this corner to this corner like this. And it looks something like this. So now we fold this edge to this point, like this. Or if you don't want to do it like this, you can fold this point to this edge like that. But I think it's easier to do this. And now remember, hold it down so that the layers don't slide. Now you have something that looks like this. And repeat. So if you open it, it looks something like this. So the next step, repeat again. Fold this edge to this edge. Like this. And now completely unfold. now we have a pattern that looks like this. So now we're going to mountain fold here. Now you know what a mountain fold is, like I showed you earlier. Mountain fold here, valley fold here. Or if you want, you can just turn it over and mountain fold. Again, turn it over mountain fold. It's easier to do it like this rather than valley folding it. So turn over mountain fold. Turn over mountain fold. Again, last time turn over and mountain fold. So now we have it like this. Now, as you can see, if you try to fold it together like this, it won't. So what we do is close it like a book. So imagine that there are four books here, and you're just closing them all at the same time. So that's how it looks like. And there you have it. So now what you do is hold it this way, hold here and shoot. It's cool, right? And fun to play. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, click the bell icon and share. Now if you notice something, this resembles a frog's tongue, right? Like when the frog opens its mouth, the tongue goes and it quickly just goes back in, right? Thank you so much for watching my video. Have fun.